Hello, I'm Dr. Schultz, and this is yet another video where I answer your questions. And I get thousands of questions from you on my website. And today's video is about the questions you have with my Echinacea Plus Herbal Tonic. So let's get started. The first question is on dosage. Dear Dr. Schultz from Anita in New Jersey. Dear Dr. Schultz, how often per week should I take the Echinacea Plus and how often for my granddaughter? Now, I have noticed that I get hundreds of questions asking me about dosages of the herbal tonics for children. So let me explain this first. And it's a rule that is often called Clark's rule, but it's how to dose for children, and it's how I dose children in my clinic. And it's the only way that you should consider to dose children or animals or people, which is by weight. By weight. And basically, the adult dose is always considered to be 150 pounds. Now, we're going to get into a little math here, my friends, but you put the weight of the child or the person or the animal over 150 pounds. So if someone weighs 150 pounds, well, 150 over 150 is one. Okay, that's the average adult dose. So if you have a child that weighs 75 pounds, 75 over 150 deduces down to the lowest fraction of being one half. That would be one half the adult dose. If you have a child or a baby that weighs 15 pounds. 15 over 150 would be one-tenth the adult dose. And if you have a horse that you're dealing with that weighs 1,500 pounds, 1,500 over 150 would be 10 over 1 or 10 times the dose. So that's how you figure out how much to give your children, how much to give adults, how much to give animals. Now, even some adults that are very slight, that might only weigh 100 pounds, well, they're not really adults. I don't care how old you are. And so these people might say, well, I'm often sensitive to herbal medicines or whatever. But it's just because they don't weigh that much. So they have a smaller metabolic ability in their body. So you want to dose them a little less than you would a 150-pound individual. So I hope this all makes sense, but that's the best way by weight to figure out a dosage, especially for children. And the Echinacea Plus, well, all my herbal tonics were basically talking about generally using two dropperfuls. Now, a dropperful is whatever comes up in the dropper. So it visually looks like about half or maybe three quarters of a dropper full. But if you were to count that out, one, two, three, four, oh God, who wants to count it out? You would find that that's about 35 drops. But instead of asking you to take 70 drops or 140 drops, we're all too busy for that. So I just count droppers full. And with all my herbal tonics, we're talking about two droppers full three times a day, or a total of six droppers full a day. But that's generally. Now, if you're having a problem, go up to three or four droppers full. If it's an extreme problem, six or eight droppers full. Now, you've heard me say this before. The only problem with taking herbs is not taking enough, because when you don't take enough herbs, they don't work and you don't get well. So don't worry about overdosing, worry about underdosing. Okay, what are we talking about? Are we talking about prevention or if you have a cold or flu? Now, a little later, I'm going to talk about how much Echinacea Plus to use for prevention and how much to treat colds and flus. But that's basically how you figure out dosages. The next question is from Jason G. from California. Jason says, Dear Dr. Schultz, I've been taking your Superfood Plus and your Echinacea Plus every day for the past 4 months. Previous to this, I was getting sick almost every 2 to 3 weeks with a new sore throat or cold. In the past 4 months that I've been taking your products, I have not been sick once and I felt great. Well, that's exciting, and that's because they're herbal formula that work. Okay, I am tooting my own horn a little bit there. Even as we have recently entered the cold and flu season and everyone around me has gotten sick, I have remained perfectly healthy. About a week ago, I was talking about your products to a friend, and my friend said to me that they were pretty sure that echinacea was not something a person should be taking every single day, but rather a few days every month. I decided this to listen to their opinion, so I stopped taking the Echinacea Plus. In only 4 days, I've just come down with a sore throat after having none for 4 months with great health. Good friend, I think. My question is, can I continue to take Echinacea Plus every day, or at least every day through the next few months until spring is here? I must say that although I did get a sore throat very soon after stopping the Echinacea Plus, I continued to take the Superfood Plus every day, and because of that, it seems that my current sore throat has not had a chance to get very bad or progress into any major cold or flu. So again, can the Echinacea Plus be taken every day? Thanks for reading this and making such wonderful products. Well, thank you, Jason. And this is a great one. We have two kinds of friends. Friends that support us in what we're doing and friends that are always there to play the devil's advocate or to warn you, oh my God, you could take too much herbs. That was probably the same friend that might have been drinking beer with you when you drank all night long and puked, and they never said, oh my God, you're drinking too much beer, or eating junk food with you, or partying with you for days on end, or God knows what else, and they didn't warn you then. But the minute you're doing something great for yourself and you're feeling great, they're out there to go, well, if you take too much echinacea, well, maybe you could burn out your immune system. You know how many times I've heard that? You know what I do when people say this to me? I slap them. No, I shake them. I do whatever I have to do. What are you talking about? I'm looking for herbal party animals here, and I've never heard of, nor never seen, or never seen a case documented of somebody that burned out their immune system or hurt themselves from taking echinacea. And it only makes sense. I like what you said. Should I take it all during cold and flu season to prevent these sore throats and colds? Why not? Because it's working for you. Do what works for you. And be wary, everybody, of all the people out there that'll warn you when you're doing the best things you're doing to take care of your health. Now, echinacea is a powerful medicinal herb, and it turns your immune system on. It tells your immune system to produce more T cells and more B cells and the chemicals you need, like the immunoglobulins that are on the surface of your B cells that help you create antibodies to bacterial and viral infections, in other words, colds and flu. So, yes, keep taking it. Can you take too much of it? No. I've never seen anybody overdose on echinacea. Should you take a break? Yeah. But maybe you don't want to take a break during cold and flu season. So, Jason, get a new friend, or tell that friend to stop being a wimp and keep taking your Echinacea Plus. The next question's from Colleen N. from Bluebell, Pennsylvania. What a wonderful sounding town. Dear Dr. Schultz, what are the ingredients of your children's echinacea? Because I'm wondering if there's a sweetener in it. Well, my ingredients are a trade secret, and I never, no. The ingredients are on the bottle, every ingredient, and all I use is herbs. And the sweetener in this, why it tastes sweet, is California fig concentrate, organic fig concentrate. This is important because with kids, you need to disguise the flavor a little bit. I used to do all sorts of things in my clinic to try to get kids to take herbal formulas. I used to put sweetener like maple syrup and fig concentrate in them. I used to put them in the freezer in popsicle holders and make popsicles, have tea parties, whatever it takes. Tie them up, duct tape them to the floor, and use a plunger. You got to get the herbs in the kids to keep them well. And so that's all it is, Colleen. Nothing to worry about. I would never use sugar because you know what sugar does? It depresses your immune system. Sugar actually inhibits and stops phagocytosis. And phagocytosis is the ability of your immune cells to eat up the garbage, the bacteria, the fungus, the virus, the cold bacteria, and the influenza in your body. So it's an important thing because you want to get your kids off of refined sugars and sugary products and drinks when they have a cold or flu. So it's California fig syrup. Here's one from Kelly M. Dear Dr. Schultz, I bought some kids' echinacea at my local health food store, and when I gave it to my daughter a couple hours later, she broke out in hives. Why is that? And if I get your product, will it do the same thing? Well, I hope not. Hives are an allergic reaction. And most people know that, A, I love health food stores. I love Whole Foods, and I love Wild Oats, and I love all the independent health food stores all around the world. And I rely on them when I travel, and I shop where if I'm in Malibu or Miami or Italy, I'm shopping in health food stores, and I love them all, and I love the food there. And, of course, I use organic markets and all of that. But there are a lot of products on the market, especially herbal products that, well, I just don't think they're very good. And sometimes you run into them in these stores. And I don't approve of them. Or they'll have sugar in them, like I just talked about. Or they'll have iffy ingredients. Or they're made with weird alchemy herbal practices where they actually take the herbs and burn them into ash and mix the ash in. Or they're homeopathic, which means they're using invisible doses of the herbs mixed with horrible things like duck crap and bee sting juice and snake venom and arsenic and lead, because homeopaths use anything, just like drug manufacturers. And look up what's in some of your homeopathic medications. People think that's herbs. Well, there may be herbs in it in invisible dosages. So obviously I'm not big on homeopathy, which is not being an herbalist and not using herbs. Not in my sense of the word. We use big doses, not in invisible doses. So where was I? What was the question? Okay, your daughter had hives. I'd take a look at the ingredients and hope they put them on the label. But I would try my children's echinacea. What can I say? I only really know about my products. And there is a lot of great stuff in health food stores, but there's some iffy stuff, and you have to weed it out. And I would discontinue use. Now, hives could have been from something completely different, too. Hives could have been from something she ate or a combination of things that she ate. It's an allergic reaction. I wouldn't really worry about it, but I would discontinue the use of that particular herbal formula. Here's one from Jessica L. from Sarasota, Florida. Can I take your Echinacea Plus with probiotics, or would the properties of Echinacea Plus destroy the probiotic? Well, some of you have heard about probiotics. Ah, that's a new high-tech term. My German mother used to call it sauerkraut, or other people would call it yogurt, or things that are fermented. Probiotics are just substances that contain friendly bacteria that help your body, because your body has a lot of friendly bacteria in it that it needs for your digestion and proper elimination. But it's a new name for things that a bacteria that's taken out of things that where they naturally occur, like sauerkraut and yogurt and things like that. I would stick with fermented vegetables like sauerkraut. There's a couple companies out there, you'll find them in the refrigerated department of your health food store, that make beautiful fermented vegetables like Regenerative Foods and Rejuvenative Foods and those companies. And you can also make them yourself, because after all, sauerkraut, well, it's a very detailed recipe. You put sauerkraut, well, you put cabbage in water and let it rot. Okay, this is fermented vegetables. And fermented vegetables contain a lot of this friendly bacteria, like lactobacillus bacteria, that's great for your guts, great for your small and large intestine and your digestion. Echinacea will not destroy the probiotic, but one of the things to remember is in my most of my extracts is some amount of alcohol, and alcohol will have a little effect on the probiotic, but there's not a large amount of alcohol, and the amount that you take of my herbal products, usually the alcohol is equal to what's in a ripe banana, so it's not a serious amount. But you might take a little more probiotic, or I got a better idea, as you can tell from this thing. Eat some sauerkraut and eat some fermented vegetables, or make some of your own yogurts without dairy products. You figure out how to do that. I've done it. It's wonderful. So I wouldn't worry about that. Here's another question from Betty M. from Wisconsin Rapids. Let's see, where would that be? In Wisconsin. Dear Dr. Schultz, this is short. How long is Echinacea Plus, I can say this, how long is Echinacea Plus good after you open the bottle? Well, I'd like you to buy it a lot and throw it away, but not really, because it's good for about 100 years. How do I know this? Well, it's a good question, because I'm not 100 years old. But years ago, there was an old herbal pharmacist in downtown San Francisco on Ellis Street named Nathan Pothurst. And I went to his pharmacy and talked with him on numerous occasions. And he had tinctures in there that he had bought around the turn of the century, not the millennium, not the 2000, but around the 1900s, in the later 1900s, in the teens, from the Lloyd Brothers Pharmacy, some of their specific medicines. He still had them, and I tasted tinctures that were 50, 60, and 70 years old at that time, and they still curled my toes. They were strong. They were powerful. So I want you to know that tinctures, one of the great things about tinctures is, A, they're extremely concentrated. We're extracting the phytochemicals or the important chemicals out of the herbs into a liquid. Okay, and when we extract that, now your stomach doesn't have to do it. You don't have to digest it. It can go to work in your bloodstream really quickly. Tinctures are also concentrated, so they're stronger than if you just ate the herbs or made an herbal tea. And of course, one of the great things is they're preserved naturally in the tonic, so they last forever. So don't worry about them going bad. The Echinacea Plus is good after opening for 10, 15, 20 years or more, maybe 100. Let's try it out. Here's one from Deborah Kay from New Jersey. Dear Dr. Schultz, my husband and I absolutely love your products. Thank you. Simply because they work. I must have hypnotized her from reading my label. After taking vitamins for over 35 years and really not feeling any better, we are so happy to have discovered your formula. My favorite is Echinacea Plus, and my husband's is Superfood. Not sure if you're aware of this, or maybe you can answer my question in reference to the Echinacea Plus. It seems like the moment I turned 50, I started to get hot flashes, although not really bad. As soon as I started taking your Echinacea Plus, the hot flashes disappear, like a switch was turned off. What's the connection or the wonderful ingredient in this formula? We wish you had a store on the East Coast. We'll just drive to California. I hope you can answer my question. Looking forward for hearing from you. Well, there are a lot of possibilities, but the reality is I have no idea. But here's the thing I say. Use it for that. Okay, and any ladies out there that haven't had luck with their hot flashes, of course, I always suggest my female formula because it has the three powerful herbs to balance your hormones. And that's the answer for PMS or menstrual problems or for menopause, is balancing your hormones. But why not try the Echinacea Plus along with it? Now, the female tonic alone does that, but this lady got relief from the Echinacea Plus. Well, what do I know? The Echinacea Plus turns your immune system on. It empowers your immune system. It makes your immune system more potent and more stronger and more powerful. And that's what I know. It gives you more immune cells and more immune chemicals and all those things I always talk about. So possibly this woman's menopausal hot flashes were irritated by her immune system being weak. And when she strengthened it, it was enough empowering of her body that her hot flashes went away. So, hey, I say try it. 5% of what I know, I learned from books. I learned in school. But 95% of what I know, I learned from my patients in the clinic. This is why clinical practice is so important. And don't listen to herbalists out there that are just armchair herbalists spouting off what they think might work based on the phytochemicals in the herbs and the anatomy and physiology of the human being. Run from them, because what they're talking about is herbal hypothesis or herbal theories. I learned what I know, or at least 95% of it, from my patients like you that came into my clinic and we did things. So I never heard this, so I'm learning something today. Try Echinacea Plus for hot flashes, along with your female tonic. So I get lots and lots of questions about my Echinacea Plus tonic, but all the questions are really based on three things. What's in it? What's it going to do for me if I take it? And how much should I take? So let me cover that. And I can maybe answer your question before you even have it. Okay, what's in it? Well, it's a combination of both Echinacea seed and Echinacea root. I use the Echinacea purpurea seed, organic, of course, and the Echinacea angustifolia root. I use the angustifolia root because that's what the American Indians used to stimulate their immune systems and for snake bites and poisonous bites and all the things they used it for. And they didn't have the knowledge we have today, but they knew which Echinacea species was the most powerful. So I blend a mixture of the Echinacea purpurea seed and the Echinacea angustifolia root. But I also add cayenne in it because cayenne is our greatest, most powerful circulation herb. And I don't just add cayenne, I add habaneros, one of the most powerful types of cayenne pepper, which makes the Echinacea get into your circulation and boost the power of how this tonic works 10 times more than if you just took Echinacea on its own. And I also add garlic. Now, a lot of people out there, you'll see Echinacea and Golden Seal and Echinacea and Golden Seal. But the bottom line is Golden Seal can't come close to the power of garlic at being a broad spectrum antibiotic, killing both gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria, but also being one of the world's most powerful natural antivirals, killing all viruses, and being one of the most powerful antifungals. So that's what's in Echinacea Plus, Echinacea seed, Echinacea root, habanero peppers, and our powerful garlic. And that's why it's called Echinacea Plus. Now, what does it do for you? Well, it does a couple things in your immune system. One is it stimulates your immune system to produce more immune cells, like all your different types of T cells that go directly out and kill invaders as they're coming in your body. They go to the front first, right to the war zone, right up to your throat, right up to your lungs, wherever they're needed to kill off bacteria and virus. Now, it helps you increase the number of B cells that you have in your body. And B cells have a chemical on the surface of them called immunoglobulin. There's many types of this chemical, and with that immunoglobulin, they create specific poisons for bacteria and virus. This is sometimes what we consider our immune system. And Echinacea increases the amount of T cells you have in your body and the amount of B cells that you have in your body. It also increases the number of macrophages, which just means big eater. And these are huge immune cells that are all over your body. You get more of them when you take Echinacea, and they run around and they just eat everything that's bad for you. Anything that isn't you, that shouldn't be inside you, that can hurt you, these macrophages eat up. Now, it also increases the amount of immune chemicals that you have in your body, like interferon and interleukin. And you often hear those chemical names in cancer treatments. But Echinacea increases the amount of immune cells and immune chemicals in your body, and also directly kills all types of bacteria, all types of virus, and all types of fungus in your body. And of course, that's assisted by this cayenne that turbocharges it through your body, and by the garlic, which doesn't even have to think. Garlic on contact kills all bacteria, all fungus, all virus, and anything that's not good for you. Okay, what's the dosage? Well, generally speaking, you take all my tonics, 2 dropperfuls, 3 times a day, or about 6 dropperfuls a day. But let's talk about preventing colds and flus. To prevent colds and flus, you do what I call my prevention drink, which is 12 dropperfuls of Echinacea Plus with 6 dropperfuls of my super tonic. I'm going to talk about that next. And put that in a sports bottle with 8 ounces of water and 8 ounces of your favorite juice and shake it up and drink that, sip that all day long. So at the end of the day, there's nothing left in the bottle. And do that for the first 6 days of every month. And that's my Echinacea Plus cold and flu prevention drink. Now, to treat colds and flus, you do it similar but a little different. You take the same dosage, 12 dropperfuls of my Echinacea Plus, 6 dropperfuls of my Super Tonic, but just put that in a couple ounces of juice like apple juice or grape juice and knock it back, gargle with it, and swallow it. Now, that's the treat. That's when you come home and you go, uh-oh, I know something's going on. I got a little fever, got some sweat going, got a sore throat. I'm coming down with something. That's the time to use Echinacea Plus for treating. And, of course, I have my new cold and flu shot that I'm going to talk about in a different video, which really has already the 12 dropperfuls of Echinacea Plus, the 6 dropperfuls of Supertonic, with a few other things. And then you just, if you want a no-brainer, that's the no-brainer to use as your prevention and your treatment drink. So that's basically what's in the Echinacea Plus, what it does in your immune system, and how to take it. So friends, really think about protecting yourself better during cold and flu season. And if you get a cold or flu, well, I just told you how to treat it. So stay well and stay healthy. And thanks for listening. Hello, I'm Dr. Schultz, and this video is another one where I answer your questions. And on this video, I'm going to answer your questions about Supertonic. Where are my questions?
We don't have any.
We don't have any? What's wrong with you? Why aren't you asking me questions about one of the greatest herbal formulas I ever made? Supertonic. Well, that's never stopped me from talking, has it? So I'm going to tell you about it anyway. So let's talk a little bit about Supertonic. What is it? What's in it? And what it's going to do for you? And what dosage to take? So here we go. Okay, what is Supertonic? Well, when I went to herbal school, every great herbalist makes what they often refer to as their plague tonic. That's an old word, you know, and herbalists made them for the plagues that killed millions and millions of people and half the populations of some cities and some countries in the history of the world. So every herbalist makes kind of their last ditch, the shit hits the fan, we better use this tonic. My dad used to say this will cure for whatever ails you, but every herbalist makes their own like super tonic. I wonder where I got the name for anything that could happen. If you're going to run out the door and you're going to grab one tonic, grab this tonic. So that's really what it is. And many of the herbal doctors that I studied with had plague tonics, and many I read about in books. But they were all a little bit difficult for me. They were all difficult to make. They were all too complex and with from herbs that you couldn't get and blah, blah, blah. And I decided when I made my plague tonic that I wanted to make it simple and easy and something that you could almost, the ingredients you could find anywhere. So really, that's how I designed my plague tonic. What's in my plague tonic? 5 herbs. This is simple, folks. 5 herbs. The first and most important ingredient that you want in a plague tonic or in my super tonic is something that's going to protect you from anything that can attack you or invade your body. And the two of the greatest protectors known are garlic and onions. Actually, a lot of people don't know they're almost the same plant, garlic and onions. And they have a lot of the same ingredients, but they destroy bacteria, they destroy virus, they destroy fungus, microbes, antigens, pathogens, and anything that can hurt you. Garlic is the most powerful at doing this. In fact, just the odor of garlic will do that. Now, I put raw organic garlic and raw organic onions and their juices into my super tonic. And let me tell you, garlic will destroy any type of bacteria, gram-positive and gram-negative. So it's a full-spectrum, natural, herbal antibiotic. Think about that, my friends. All the times you would want to use an antibiotic, but you don't want to because we know they can harm you and destroy your natural bacteria. Garlic actually enhances your natural bacteria, your intestinal flora, but it kills off all the bad invaders. So it's a broad spectrum antibiotic. Now, it's also one of the most potent antivirals known, which means it kills influenza and all types of influenza. So unlike a flu shot where mankind is trying to decide what flu are we going to have next year and then mixing something together to kill it, and it never works, of course, garlic has antiviral compounds in it that absolutely destroy all known viruses. And of course, garlic is a potent antifungal, so it destroys microbes, pathogens, which cause disease in your body, antigens, things that are against life, that destroy life in your body. So garlic and onions, first main ingredients in Supertonic. Now, secondly, I have horseradish in there because we all know that horseradish goes up to your head and it cuts through mucus. And one of the things that happens when you are infected with anything is cells that fight it off, like your T cells and B cells that I talk about with echinacea, once they die after they fight off the bacteria, the virus, they create mucus in your body. And the horseradish cuts through, thins the viscosity of, and helps you eliminate and get rid of this mucus that's in your body. And the last two ingredients, some of the most powerful ingredients, cayenne, not just cayenne, but habanero peppers and ginger root. And they are the two greatest circulation boosters that I know. Habaneros, well, nothing stimulates your circulation like that and the blood flow in your body. The minute you put them in your mouth, you see your face go red, and that's blood being driven to the extremities of your body. Now, ginger goes to the extremities first and works backwards, so you have this incredible, powerful balancing act of habaneros and ginger. And I don't just use any white crap ginger. I use Hawaiian organic yellow ginger, 3 times, maybe 10 times more powerful. And this powerful combination of cayenne and ginger goes throughout your body to stimulate your circulation. So what do you have here? You have herbs that directly kill any invaders, the garlic and the onions. You have herbs that cut through the mucus, which is the leftover of that war between your body, and that's the horseradish root. And you have the two strongest herbs to blast your circulation, which is what you need when you're invaded, because you need to get this stuff to the invaders, to the war zone, to the front lines faster. So that's what's in it. Okay, what's the dosage? Well, you can use it in a lot of different ways. First off, I still claim that Supertonic is the world's greatest salad dressing. Mix it with a little bit of organic extra virgin olive oil, and you have, no doubt, the world's greatest salad dressing. But as a tonic, as Supertonic, what's the dosage? Well, you can take a couple dropperfuls or 2 droppers full 3 times a day, which is my dosage for all my herbal tonics. But you can take it all different ways. You can just swig some out of the bottle, gargle with it. It's important to disinfect this area, especially during cold and flu season, because you're going to get invaded through your nose or through your mouth. Not through your elbow, not through your kneecap, not through the bottom of your feet. You're going to be invaded by cold bacteria and by virus from influenza through your nose and through your mouth. So if you take the Supertonic and chug a bit and gargle with it and get all those fumes and all those herbs around your mouth and swallow it, you're killing the bacteria and the virus before it even stands a chance at invading your body. So that's one of the best ways to use it. And I also use it in my cold and flu blaster drink to treat colds and flus. I use it in my cold and flu prevention drink. And both of those are on the Echinacea Plus question and answer video and in all my literature. And I also, it's an ingredient in my cold and flu shot. And that's on that video with all that literature. So friends, if you're running out the door and you want to know what's going to save your butt in an emergency, it's my Supertonic. And start writing me some questions about it. Thanks. Hello friends, I'm Dr. Schultz, and this video is about answering your questions about my cold and flu herbal shot. So let's get started. First question from Kelly K. Cottonwood, Minnesota. Dear Dr. Schultz, are the cold and flu shots for children also? If so, should they take the full dose? How often are you to drink it? Good questions. Okay, are the cold and flu shots for children also? Just remember that you always dose children based on weight, over 150 pounds and what fraction they weigh. So an adult dose is 150 pounds. If they weigh 75 pounds, give them half the adult dose. So that would be half the shot. If they weigh less or more, base it on the weight. Remember, their weight over 150, deduce it to the smallest fraction, call the math teacher if necessary, and find out what the dosage is. Now remember, my shots are hugely powerful, industrial strength adult doses. They're wow. They won't hurt kids, but most of them, when you shake them and knock them back and drink them, they take your breath away. So I don't necessarily suggest them for the lighthearted of kids. Now, you can certainly take a shot, mix it with things like with sweeteners, like organic maple syrup or some sweet juice like grape juice, and make it into popsicles or whatever you need to do. And it won't hurt kids at all, but they're usually going to object to the taste of some of my shots. Now, my son, he was used to garlic and every possible herbal formula by the age of 3 or 4. But if your kids aren't used to it, it might be a little bit of a shock. So present it slowly. Make sure to smile when you give it to him. Don't go, here's the worst thing you can do to a kid. Go, here, take this. Because they're going to go, why would I want to do that? You look scared. You look freaked out. Okay, shots are fine for kids, but remember, they're powerful in taste and powerful in action. If they should they take the full dose? Well, I just answered that. No, base it on their weight. And how often should you drink it? Well, I have two programs with the shot. I'm sure I'll talk about it here, but it's one shot a day for 6 days is my prevention program, or 1 to 5 shots as needed for a cold and flu. And I'll talk more about that later. Okay, here's one from Carol C. from California. Dear Dr. Schultz, we just received your cold and flu herbal shot, and we're not quite sure how to take it. We did your prevention regime before. We took 3 dropperfuls of echinacea and 3 dropperfuls of supertonic a day for 2 weeks on, 2 weeks off from October on. Well, I appreciate that, but that's not enough. My prevention drink would be 12 dropperfuls of echinacea plus and 6 dropperfuls of supertonic during the day for 6 days. Or you could do it for 2 weeks on and 2 weeks off. The bottom line is it sounds like you didn't get sick, so whatever you're doing, keep doing it. So do we take 6 bottles of the shot for prevention purposes? Yes. For the prevention purposes, how to prevent colds and flus during cold and flu seasons, and this is a minimum, take 1 shot a day for 6 days, the first 6 days of every month, for the month, to prevent colds and flus. Now, how do you do that? Well, you can just shake it up. I suggest you take a sports bottle and shake it up and pour it in the sports bottle and add 8 ounces of water and 8 ounces of your favorite juice, and then just take that out with you during the day. And as the day goes on, sip out of that bottle and make sure when you come home, when you drive home, when you get home, the bottle's empty. Now you know you had your 1 shot during the day, spread out through the day. It works really good that way, and that stimulates your immune system, all the things I talked about with echinacea. I hope that answers your question. Here's another one from Switzerland. Okay, dear Dr. Schultz, I just watched your cold and flu shot video, but still haven't got an answer to a question. How often should I drink it for prevention purposes? I just answered that question. Here's one from Cynthia L. in Northridge, California. Dear Dr. Schultz, I love your products. I always accent it because we all need lots of love. In fact, the most alkalinizing of anything, more than food, one of the most healing things that you can ever do for yourself and others is love. So let me reread this from Northridge, California. Dear Dr. Schultz, I love your products. I just received the cold and flu shot, and I am not clear of how to take it for prevention. Just answer this. How to take it, but you just don't say how long. Well, there it is. For 6 days every month, use 6 bottles of my cold and flu shot. Here's another one. from Lois B. From Pennsylvania. Dear Dr. Schultz, I purchased the cold and flu shots. The girl I talked to on the phone said to take one a month. You're fired, whoever you are. No, you don't take one a month. There's no explanation on the bottle. Okay, it seems as though a lot of the questions are about dosage, so you'll be very clear on the dosage watching this video, because I'm going to talk more about it in a minute. Here's one from Gary in Laurel, Montana. Dear Dr. Schultz, how do you take the cold and flu shot? Is it one bottle a day? Seems as though I've not been clear on the dosages. Here's one from D in North Carolina. How often do I take it? Here's one from Monica, Pasadena, California. I love it. I take it every day. Is there any harm to taking it every day? No, there's no harm, especially during cold and flu season. Now, the dosage, remember, is you shake it up, you knock it back, you gargle with it, and you swallow it. But you don't have to do the whole bottle. If you're not having a raging fever, a sore throat, and a cold, if you're not doing it for prevention, you could take a bottle out with you in the car and just sip on it all day long. You can break my rules, and you can make decisions for yourself. Remember, it's a medical doctor that's telling you that you're stupid, you don't know anything, and follow my directions. I'm telling you, you're really smart, you know a lot, you have great common sense, you have better intuition about you and your body than I do, so follow your own rules, seek your own truths. There's no harm in taking this every day, especially during cold and flu season. Here's one from Angela. Dear Dr. Schultz, I would like to purchase your flu shot. Just make sure that you don't put it in a hypodermic needle and inject it into your body. That is, don't do that. I'd like to purchase it for my family to protect us from this new swine flu. Your product comes in a package of 6, and I'm wondering how many to get for the family of 5. So I'm not sure how to do this. Well, 6 times 5 is how much, folks? Sounds like 30 to me. That would be 30 bottles. Better yet, it comes in a 6-pack, so get 5 6-packs. Okay. Will it protect you from the swine flu? It'll protect you from any flu. And the swine flu is not a new flu. Most of these flus, the various strains, have been around for hundreds, if not thousands of years. They just come back in different cocktails and different mixtures. And this new swine flu could be very deadly and dangerous. And if you want to do prevention for that, you would do it the same as I discussed prevention throughout this video. Okay. Here's one from Cole H. in Illinois. Dear Dr. Schultz, I have anxiety, which also causes my blood pressure to rise when I'm under stressful times and situations. I was wondering if I can take your new cold and flu shots. The reason I asked this is because I read the ingredients and it contains coffee bean, kola nut, and licorice. I have not read that all of these can raise my blood pressure, and maybe they're not recommended for me. I think they said that I have read that these can raise my blood pressure, and they're not recommended for someone with anxiety. Well, there's a very, very small amount of coffee bean and kola nut in this formula. So it contains a very small amount of caffeine, about what would be in 1/80th of a cup of coffee. So it's nothing to be concerned about at all. It just helps the herbs activate and move around your body and helps dilate your bronchioles. Powerful enough to do that, but not irritate you or cause you to not have sleep or affect you with your anxiety. But better yet, let's do something about your anxiety. And I know this is the cold and flu shot video, but you need to also be investigating and taking my nerve tonic, which is specifically for anxiety, panic attacks, spasms, whether they're in your body or in your mind. It's an antispasmodic, it's a nervine, it's a sedative. 2 dropperfuls 3 times a day. And when you're having an anxiety or a panic attack, 4 dropperfuls, 6 dropperfuls if you need it to stop that attack. Secondly, I would use the Superfood Plus, because that has the B vitamins that are the food, like acetylcholine, a neurotransmitter, a B vitamin complex nutrient in the superfood to feed and build. And this is pure food, pure nerve food, pure pure food for your nervous system. So you want to think about the nerve formula, my nerve tonic, and the superfood, and also doing some psychotherapy, my friend. You can even do it in a self-help way. Get a lot of books on it. Get positive. Look at all the affirmations that are in my books and start saying those affirmations about 2,947 times a day. Well, that might give you more anxiety just all the time. Get positive. Love life. Get rid of people around you that don't love life or don't love you. And let's get rid of that anxiety. Hey, you might even try the bowel flush shot. It's been amazing, but I had a lot of people with a lot of anxiety. And when you're thinking about your butt, you're not thinking so much about your head or with your head. So try cleaning out your bowel too, Cole. Here's one from Teresa M. Dear Dr. Schultz, I'm allergic to echinacea, so how could I possibly take your formula? Whoever told you that is a liar. No one's allergic to echinacea. In fact, I don't believe in any allergies to really natural substances. I come from the school of thought that if you're allergic to things like strawberries or garlic, that's not an allergic reaction. That's a detoxification, my friend. And you just found something wonderful that's helped will help drive poisons out of your body. So take a little bit of those substances and move forward with that. Now, if you're allergic to nylon and gasoline fumes, you know what? We're all allergic to that. It's toxic. But if you feel sensitive to echinacea, just start with a small dose and work yourself up, and you're going to be fine. Trust me, you're going to be fine. Here's one from Annie S. from San Diego, California, sunny San Diego. I've been taking your flu shot at the beginning of the month since October. I've had a sinus infection for 9 days. On day one, when I knew I was starting a cold sinus drainage, I took the flu shot straight. I continued to have symptoms with sore throat and cough developing. I started having the green stuff in my sinuses. Then I was coughing it up, so I took another flu shot straight on day 7, and 2 days later, still the green stuff. Should I take more cold and flu? Well, I'm a little confused about your letter, but one thing I know is that the cold and flu shot works. It's a miracle in a bottle. So if you're having a lot of infected sinuses, you may want to add to the cold and flu shot, because one of the great things in the cold and flu shot, remember it's a combination of formulas, but one of the formulas specifically for your sinuses is the Super Tonic. So I would also get a bottle of Super Tonic and gargle with that multiple times a day while you're using your cold and flu shot. I would also get my air detox formula and spray it around your house so you're breathing it in. Maybe take a nice sauna or a steam and use the air detox and really breathe that in, because that's going to disinfect. But if you're having a lot of problem with mucus and green mucus, it sounds like you're really prone to sinus infections, my friend. And you would really take a look at your food program and how well your bowel's working. The old in and out. Remember, the quality of what's going in your body, because a lot of things cause mucus and sinus infections. And if I could think of one thing, it would be dairy products. They're full of mucus. They create mucus in the body. They create allergic reactions. People say, I'm lactose intolerant. You know what? Everybody in the world is cow lactose intolerant. It's not a natural food for our bodies, my friend. And we're in cold and flu season. Maybe when you're watching this, get rid of the dairy products. Cow's milk is a beautiful food with lots of fat and protein and hormones to create a 3,000-pound cow, not a human being. And if you're thinking of goat milk or monkey milk or baboon milk, you know, maybe they're closer to human milk, but the only milk that was ever designed for your body, my friends, was your mother's milk out of her own breasts. That was for you, and it's over. Okay, I know you still like breasts, you men out there, but it's over. Okay, the only time to have milk is when everybody's laughing in here. But the only time to have milk is when you're 0 to 1.5 years, maybe a little longer. And then it's not a food for you anymore. And when you take it after that age, you develop a lot of sinus and a lot of mucus. And if you're prone to sinus problems or lung problems, it's going to make it a lot worse. So get rid of all the dairy products in your life and make sure you clean your house and it's nice and clean and all those things. I know that will help you, Anne. Okay, here's one from Krista. And Krista says, I have 2 children, ages 2 and 5. Are your flu and cold remedies safe for use on children? If yes, is this gauged by the child's weight? Absolutely. Very, very good. Okay, you can use all my herbal formula, any of them, for children. But you have to remember to dose your children appropriately, and you do that by weight. And if they can tolerate the taste, and if they can't, add a little maple syrup, sweeten it up, and you'll get it down them. Smile a lot and make it a party. I have used your products for myself and know the wonderful benefits, but I would sure like to share them with my kids this fall and winter. Share them with your kids this fall and winter. Okay, here's one from Michael in Claremont, California. Dear Dr. Schultz, does it matter what time of day I take the cold and flu herbal shot? And does it matter if I take it before or after a meal? Let me think about that. No, it doesn't matter. Take it anytime you want. Take it before or after meals. It doesn't really matter. The most important thing is to take it. Get in a routine. Set it somewhere in your house where you're going to remember it every day, whether that's the bathroom, whether that's the kitchen, whether you tape it to the steering wheel of your car. Do whatever you have to do to remember to take your cold and flu shot. Here's one from Sue A. in Pagosa Springs, Colorado. Dear Dr. Schultz, have you totally replaced your cold and flu tonic with the cold and flu shot? No, I haven't. I like to have a whole broad spectrum symphony, orchestra of herbal formulas for you to use out there to see which ones use that make sense for you, see which ones that you feel better when you take, to mix and match on your own and create your own program. I've used the clinical air treatment for years and I love it. Has it also been replaced or just renamed? Yes. I have to rename my products all the time. It's not because I'm a wishy-washy person. It would be because of the FDA and all these other three-lettered government organizations that are always up my butt and on my back and telling me what I can't do. I don't like to get into the politics of my friends. In my clinic, I used a lot of herbs. I used illegal herbs, and I can say that because my clinic's over. It's been shut down and it's done. I don't get into the politics. I get into one thing. What's going to help you get well? So I have to change my names all the time. There's new name changes coming up. Sorry about that, my friends, but I'm going to have to do the dance and to keep selling my herbs. And that's the bottom line. Okay, here's one from Monica D. In Westfield, Massachusetts. Dear Dr. Schultz, is the cold and flu shot product, can I use it for my children ages 2 and 3? Absolutely. You could use Echinacea Plus and Supertonic. You can dilute it with juice. You could use the cold and flu shot. Use the appropriate dose and dilute it. Can you do the prevention method? And here's a big question. Can I avoid vaccines altogether? Well, Monica, if you've read any of my literature, you know how I feel about cold and flu medications, and certainly how I feel about the influenza vaccine. First of all, if you read any of my literature, you'll see that most of the important people that know about vaccines in the world say it, they don't work. Okay, well, why wouldn't they work? Because they're a lie. And why are they a lie? Because you have to predict the future and know exactly what viruses we're going to get hit with every year before we make the billion bottles of vaccines. And nobody ever does that. So they kind of guess at what we had last year and what they hope might be coming this year. And they get out their pendulum and their crystal ball and call all their drug psychics. I don't know. But this is why the flu shot never works. The only thing it seems to do is make you sick and give you the flu that is in that shot. So I'm not for flu shots at all. I never advised any of my patients to use them, even if they were children and even if they were older people that are more susceptible to certain flus, saying that flus like the bird flu and the swine flu and big pandemics of flus tend to kill and maim and hurt and make sick most people in the prime of their life, in their 20s and 30s. But aside from that, I never, ever, ever suggest flu shots unless you think filling your body with ethylene glycol, which is antifreeze for a car, and mercury, which is a toxic, poisonous, heavy metal. And let's see, what's the active ingredient in flu shots? That would be animal pus from diseased organs of animals that died from these infections. No, I don't think taking all that stuff, mixing it up, boiling it up, concentrating it, and then injecting it under your skin is a good idea. It's a very, very bad idea. So friends, here's the bottom line. It's cold and flu season. You need to prevent yourself and your family and your loved ones from getting sick. You can do that with the cold and flu shot. Follow my prevention program. And if you have a cold or flu, you can treat it with my cold and flu shot. Let's stay healthy this winter. Let's not get sick. And if we do, let's teach those germs a lesson to get out of our body and not come back. Stay healthy, my friends. Thanks.